Space Marine Adventures Rise of the Orcs. This is one of these games set in the Warhammer universe. It is a standalone game, so good for people like me who do not play the real Warhammer because I don't want to start that lifestyle slash religion slash big commitment than it is. But I don't mind playing a self-contained game that comes out of the box, has everything that I need to play, and then goes back in the box, and then I can go back to my real normal life. This is a cooperative game that can also be played in solitaire, and this is how I played it. So I played the game by myself, controlling all characters against the hordes of monsters. In the game you have these five space marines, represented by these very nice miniatures. The box says that you can build them without tools and without glue, and I'm happy to report that that is true. I had my doubts, but I was able to build them without any tools and without any glue, and they do look great. And since I do not build or paint miniatures, I was pretty happy that they still look so good. These five marines will start from those hexes there in the middle of the board. This is the board in case you hadn't figured it out, in case you weren't paying attention. You always have those five marines. All of them are in play regardless of how many players there are. You simply divide them among all the players. Each marine, each miniature has a corresponding card. You will place a token here. When the marine takes damage, the token goes up. When the token reaches that number there, that space there, the marine is out of action, and we record that by moving a token that is there down by one space. The marine will then come back slightly recovering 1 point of life, but the overall grit of the group has been reduced. If it goes down to zero, then the player or players lose the game. You see these spaces here, they also contain reactors. The orcs will enter the board wave after wave after wave. They will enter from these areas here, the numbered areas. They'll move towards the reactor, trying to reach the reactors or pummel the space marines in the face, whichever is most convenient to them. If they destroy all of the reactors, then the players also lose the game. The only way for the player or players to win the game is to destroy all of the orcs in the game. When you set up the game, you will choose one of these setup instructions here that will tell you the composition of the horde that you're facing, and also the number of orcs that will enter the board. And so you will have these tokens here representing different types of orcs. Some have special powers, some don't, but they're not that different from one another. Special powers or not, every orc has a number of movement points, a number of damage points it inflicts on the marine if they get to attack the marine, which they do if they end their movement adjacent to a marine, and the toughness, the number that you have to meet or exceed with an attack roll in order to defeat that orc. So after you have selected the type and number of orcs indicated on your setup card, again, you prepare the orc pool, you shuffle those orcs face down, and then each turn, you will add the required number of orcs. For each orc that you need to add, you roll a die, and an orc is added to the corresponding space. If a space has already been occupied, then you place a new orc in an adjacent space, like so. And suppose that's what happened after we set up the game. Or at the beginning of each turn. So during setup and at the beginning of each turn, a new horde or a new wave of the horde enters the game and is placed on the board. Then the marines get to act. Each marine can move and then attack, or attack and then move, or only move or only attack. After that, the orcs move. Now, remember these cards, each marine has a command value, and the marines will activate in decreasing command order. So I already placed them here. in the order in which they will activate, from this one to this one. When a marine moves, it moves the number of spaces. When it attacks, each marine has a different attack system, or to say specific rules. This one just shoots everybody in a single line. This one has two attacks, which kind of like meh. This one has three attacks, but they have to be against the same target or against adjacent targets. This one has the rockets that blow up. So there are different ways in which they attack, but ultimately the attack is resolved always in the same way, which is you roll a six-sided die, you apply possible modifiers, and if you meet or exceed the toughness of the orc you're targeting, kabooey, the orc is removed. Other things, these spaces on the board here, the black spaces are impassable, and they block line of sight. And then, for line of sight, there are a couple of things that are a little strange, and the phrasing in the rulebook is not great. So I'm going to explain to you how I understand it, and how I played it, and if it's wrong, I'm still going to describe how I played it. If you have line of sight, if I understand what the rulebook says, if you have a line of sight template, and you can trace a line from, how I understand it, any point of the hex of the marine and any point of the hex of the orc. If you can reach the center of the hex of the marine and connect it with the center of the hex of the target orc, then you have a clear shot and you just shoot. If you can touch your hex with the hex of the target, but not center to center, then you have a penalty of -1 to your die roll, or you can think of it as the toughness is increased by 1. That's how I understood being in cover. And in cover means you can reach the hex, but not the center of the hex with the center of your hex. If that's the case, how I understood the rules, certainly would have been nice to have a little dot at the center of each hex. And this is how it works. You know what? Here's the rules. Pause, feel free to read them and see if you... Nope, that's the wrong page though. There you go. Pause and see if you get the whole idea about in cover, if I got it right or you got it wrong. Decide for yourself. Orcs arrive. Move and attack, attack and move, bam, bam, bam. Then the orcs move up to their full movement allowance. They do stop if they move adjacent to a marine, and they also stop if they enter an area with a reactor, in which case they destroy it. When they end their movement adjacent to a marine, they inflict their number of hit points on the marine automatically. That's how useless those armors are. Why do you even wear them? Are they made of cardboard? I don't understand. That's just weird. One last thing, these areas here, these hexes here, they have tokens of that kind. When a marine enters a space like that, it still has that token. The token is removed, and the player that controls the marine draws two cards from this deck and then keeps one. And these cards simply will give you different types of advantages. Some are generic, some are associated to specific marines. And then we have these tokens here of the reactors. When the reactor is okay, flip to this side. When the reactor has been destroyed by an orc standing next to it. This is the game. Continue like this, having new ways of orcs. Move and attack, attack and move with your marines. Then the orcs move and possibly break stuff or hit the marines. And continue like this until you destroy all the orcs, in which case you win, or you lose a number of marines, or you lose all of the reactors, in which case you lose. Rise of the Orcs is not a bad game, but it's not a particularly amazing one either. I played better, I played worse, sort of middle of the road. there is fun in being able to create or to experience a cooperative experience, which is out of the box. Here's the adventure, the monsters are coming, and you are trying to destroy them. What's not to love about them? In that sense, it reminded me a little bit of an old game from the 90s. I think it was called Star Crusade or Space Crusade. It had different names in different countries. It was sort of like Hero Quest in space with guys with big armors. That was competitive though. One player was the aliens, one player the big soldiers. But this, the beautiful simplicity of the experience, blowing stuff up, blowing monsters that are coming from all directions, it's definitely right there. Space Hulk is another great game. So this looks like a smaller game for when you don't want to set up the big experience, the big thing, which is great. It's the kind of thing that usually I like. I just feel that here maybe they simplified too much, they took out too much of the flavor, and in that sense, the minor version, it's just not all that interesting anymore. Again, there is fun in solving what really feels like a mega epic adventure turned into a puzzle. And there is some fun to be had in solving that puzzle. Figuring out how to maneuver your soldiers, how to try to move the orcs. Actually, sometimes I feel the game is mainly about the orcs much more than the Marines. Maybe that's what's called Rise of the Orcs. Because how to move them within the rules without breaking any of the rules or their movement priorities, but for example, put them in a line so that the guy that can kill several of them in a line will do that. How to bunch them together, again, within the rules so that then we can throw a missile at them. It just feels like a puzzle, which I don't say is a negative thing. What is a little bit more negative is that the game just feels repetitive because you just have this wave of monsters that keep coming and keep coming and keep coming and keep coming. And that's all they do. And wave after wave, you just don't have a lot of variety. Many orcs, the only difference really is just they inflict one more point of damage or one less point of damage, one more toughness, less toughness. Other do other stuff, but it's really not enough to make up for the hordes and the waves of monsters that don't do anything other than advance, just like the brothers that you just slaughtered dead, and the brothers that you will slaughter next will do. It just feels too bland and too simplistic to me, and just a little repetitive, and just fairly repetitive. Again, from time to time, I don't think I'll have anything against playing this game, but at the same time, also, there are just other games with a similar comparable level of difficulty that scratch the same itch of, you know, a cooperative game, and they just have better decisions, more exciting decisions, and more tension. There is tension. That's it's fun to see that you look like you're in control, then a couple of bad rolls throw everything out of balance, and you're scrambling to prevent them from killing the last Marine or destroying the last reactor. It can have some cool, interesting, tense moments, but they are overall surrounded by a fairly repetitive, redundant mechanism, and that to me just weakens the experience a lot. If this came out in 1990, this would have been a blast. By the standards of 2020, we just have a lot of games that have comparable level of simplicity, and they just have a richer tree of decisions and just more interesting gameplay overall. The production looks great, but you have a couple of minor unpolished elements here. A game this simple, there is no excuse why there should be gray areas in the manual. Things like that. The map could be a little clearer, maybe also look a little more interesting. There's just something a little weird in that abstract. It's both very thematic and yet abstract somehow. And again, dots that mark the center of the axis, I think, would have been very important. Rise of the Orcs, not so bad, but also not particularly exciting or remarkable, especially by the standards of the Renaissance Obergaming that we are all experiencing these days.